If you want to create an AEM app using Angular.js components so that they can be added into a page, in this series, you will learn how. Keep watching. Hi there. I'm Manuel Gutierrez from thelighthouse.co, and I make videos that help you learn about different programming topics like AEM, Docker, TensorFlow, Unity, and more. So, if you're new here, hit the subscribe and the bell notification buttons below so you don't miss a thing. Let's start! It's really simple to create an AEM app with support for Angular.js components using Adobe's archetype. You will need AEM 6.4 Service Pack 2 or newer for this video. I'm going to use AEM 6.5. So let's create the app from scratch. I am providing the most important properties in a single line here. Notice that the version that I'm using is the 23rd and that the frontend module property was set to Angular. After that, the archetype creates a folder called UI.frontend for our Angular application. I am going to focus on the SRC apps components folder where all the Angular components are located. Change to the directory for our new AEM application. And let's build and deploy our new app. Make sure that you have AEM up and running. For creating an AEM component using Angular.js, we need at least four things. A skeleton AEM component with a dialog, an Angular component, an entry importing the component inside the app.module.ts file, and a Sling model, which I'll be configuring in the next video. I'm going to use the Yeoman generator for creating the skeleton AEM component for me, with some additional example fields inside the dialog. I am calling it basic component, and I am making sure that the names for the folders and component group match my current application's configuration. After that, we should end up with a component inside Angular Simple Example Components called Basic Component. If you check the dialog's XML file, you will find two example fields, one for the text and another for the checkbox. Given that we are using Angular for this component, we will ignore the HTML script. Before creating the component, make sure that you have the Angular command line interface by first installing it in your computer. Let's use Angular's CLI to create a simple component for us. In your console or terminal, change to the UI.frontend folder inside our application and use ng-generate-component with the name of the component to be created inside the components subfolder. This command will create the basic component folder, a couple of files for the CSS, HTML, TypeScript, and tests for the component. I'm going to remove the tests for this video. The command also modifies the app.module.ts by adding the component into the declarations property. If we open the TypeScript file, we should see a simple Angular.js component already created. Notice that given that I am naming it basic component, it has the word component twice. In a typical application, you would not add the word component explicitly, and this should not be an issue. But I'm keeping it for this example to have some consistency between the AEM component inside apps and this one here. Let's first add the imports at the top for the Map2Helper library from Adobe, and add also input to the list of imported objects from the Angular core module. create an edit config object, which will be used for displaying some text when the component is empty. In this case, given that the component's properties, like the ones defined on the dialog, are available through the CQ model object, we can just check if CQ model.text doesn't have a value so that we can mark this component as empty. Then, on the component, add the properties for text and checkbox using the @input annotation. Finally, we call mapToHelper function that maps the Angular component to a particular resource type inside AEM, so that AEM knows which AngularJS component to use when rendering our page. On the HTML, we render the values for the text and checkbox properties inside the component. Then, inside the app.module.ts file, given that the component has already been imported, just add it into the entry components array, given that the components are added dynamically into the page. Go to the root folder for the application, build and deploy the application again. Open the homepage for your new AngularJS simple example site inside AEM. If you don't see the basic component in the list, go to the Page Information button and click on Edit Template. Click on the Layout container and then on Policy. Scroll down and select the AngularJS Simple Example-Content group and click on Save. Go back to your page and refresh. You should be able to see the basic component now. Add the component into the page and some text. Check the checkbox and click on Save. Finally, refresh the page to see the changes. In the next video, we will be configuring the Sling model also so that we no longer have to refresh the page per each edition. Awesome! Congratulations and thanks for watching! You can join the free mini course associated with this video by clicking on the link in the description below. Share any comments or suggestions about the series or future topics. And if you like the video, also hit the like button below.